Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing a plan with me video in my memory keeping planner, and it is for the week of January 2nd to 8th. Today is January 8th, the Sunday, so this week has already passed, so I'm able to share with you guys what has been going on throughout the whole week. And I was originally going to be using this kit from Simply Ginger Co. as my main New Year's kit, my main planner, but she did come out with a different one, which I ended up using. So this kit is the Midnight Beauty kit, and this is what the kit actually comes with. So you have your full boxes here, you have your Ombre heart checklist, you have your functional sheet with icon, script icon, weekend banner, heart checklist, flags, appointment labels, you have your half boxes and your headers, you have here your little things, you have some three heart checklist, appointment labels, and some sidebar items, and here you have your washi. So without further ado, why don't we just get right into the planning. Since this is a happy planner and there is polka dots on the bottom of the page, we are going to actually take the pages out so that I could actually white out the bottom portion here. So now I have those whited out, and these portions here will be covered with washi, so I don't bother whiting them out. We'll fold the planner in half so it's easier for me to place the washi. And I will have to trim this washi here because this is, again, the Erin Condren washi. So if you haven't watched any of my spare or memory keeping plan with me's, then you know, or if you have, then you would know that you can use Erin Condren stickers very, very easily in your happy planner with no issues. All you have to do is trim down the bottom washi, and that is the only change that you have to make. Now I'm going to be doing my ombre heart checklist, and I don't really like the dark color, so I'm going to put only one of them, and it's going to be in the middle of the week. I did recently purchase a monthly kit and as well as a weekly kit from her, and I didn't realize because I got a new phone recently and I didn't change the settings on Etsy. They have it automatically set to US dollars, so I was wondering why her kits were cheaper, so I decided to go ahead and get the premium mat until I realized that it was too late until I realized that it was actually set in the US dollar, which was fine. So it was a couple dollars more, and she did have a discount. So code for, I think it was last weekend when I ordered it, so it was fine. So we'll see if I like that or not, because I have tried premium matte from another shop for the monthly view, and so far I do like it. The quality is really good, but the only thing I'm not really too fond of is because I use a Sharpie pen to write with, so I have to let it fully dry before I can like touch it or like close the planner or anything like that. And also if I decide to write any like kind of fancier kind of lettering, and if I use more ink on a certain thing, it tends to like to smudge, so I won't be able to do that kind of thing. So that's the only downside to that about getting premium matte, but you'll definitely see that. Right now I'm going to do my little things. So as usual, I like to do my meals here, and I like to match for the colors for each day. So I'll start on the bottom with my meals. So this past week was actually kind of crazy. So I don't know if you know, I don't know if I've even mentioned it in any of my videos, but for Christmas, my husband got me a new phone. It actually didn't come on Christmas, in time for Christmas, but we were away, and then when we came back from holidays, my phone arrived. So that was beside the point of what I'm trying to say here. So I got my phone, and then on the second, so on the Monday here, I decided, because there was a notification on my phone that says to update to the new operating system to upgrade to Android 7. So Oxygen operating system, I think it was 4. So I decided to do that because my husband also got, he has the same phone, but he's had his phone since August. And so he also got the update on his phone. So he decided to actually go ahead and do the update. So I did as well the same time he did his. And then after I did it and everything was ready, I wasn't able to use my data. I do have in my cell phone plan, I have unlimited data, so I just like to use data because it's easier for me. So when I'm on the go and stuff, I can, when I'm out and about, I can use internet. I don't have to worry about having to do Wi-Fi and stuff. So I've really never really used Wi-Fi, only when I was in Mexico last year, because obviously I'm out of the country, so I had to use Wi-Fi. So it was really annoying that changing into the new operating system, I wasn't able to use Wi-Fi. I mean, to use my data. So I looked around online to see what was going on, and apparently that was one of the many issues that Android 7 has. So I don't recommend any of you guys getting Android 7. Upgrading, even if your phone says you're ready to upgrade to Android 7 to the new operating system or whatever, don't do it, because it's really, really bad. There's a lot of issues, and a lot of people have issues, one of which you're unable to use your data. So I tried to just figure out what to do, and I couldn't do anything about it. So I'm gonna do my hubby's work. So I wasn't able to do anything about it. So I contacted my cell phone provider the next day, because at that time the customer service line was it was done for the day, like their, I guess, operating hours. So the next morning, so whenever their operating hours started, I think it was like 8 a.m. I woke up at 8, and then I called them, and then they said that it wasn't something they could do because I didn't buy the phone from them, because my hubby, like, we just bought the phone. We didn't actually get it from them or anything like that. So they said we had to contact the phone itself. It's a OnePlus 3 phone, if you're really, really curious. It's a really good phone, but there were just some issues with the new operating system. So, so I didn't know what to do. And then I think it was the same day on Tuesday. I went to the OnePlus 3 website, and I found that there was this live chat thing, because I don't really like talking to people on the phone and stuff like that. And I don't have one color for this day, which kind of sucks. Let's see what I want to do about that first. Oh, she does have these asterisks, so I can use one of these TV ones, because I don't really do TV, and I just put an asterisk there. So yeah, so on the same day, I decided to go on the OnePlus 3 website, and then there was live chat. So I chatted with a tech support person, I guess, there on their live chat, and then they told me to do something, like press like some buttons to try to do something to reboot my phone, and nothing worked when I rebooted my phone. Basically, they scheduled me with a level 2 tech support so that person can do remote access, and they can help me revert back to my old operating system, so back to basically Android 6, and my old operating system was Oxygen OS 3.something, or rather, I don't know exactly, basically back to the before I got the upgrade. So they were able to do that. So it was scheduled for Friday of the week. So on Friday, I had to do that, and I did. And it takes about, they say 45 minutes to an hour. It takes more like half hour to 45 minutes. I did it, and I revert back to the old system. And so immediately I turned off my Wi-Fi to see if the data works, and I was able to download all my apps and everything, because it actually ends up resetting your phone, so you have to download all the apps back on your phone and stuff like that. So I ended up doing it, and it works fine. But it's really funny, because the data, I am on, I think, LTE data, or it's actually the fastest data. It's actually faster than 4G for data. So it actually went back to H, which, when you look it up online, because I did look it up online when it was like my data was all messed up and everything, H is somewhere between 3G and LTE, so it's between 3G and 4G, I think. So it's not the fastest, but it is pretty fast. But nonetheless, I'm still able to use my data, which was the main concern, which was good now, because now that it's fixed. But it's kind of sad that it is still not LTE, not like the fastest, but in terms of being able to use it, I'm now able to use my data again. Long story short, don't upgrade to the new Android system. I really, really, really don't recommend that at all. I don't know why it happened to my phone. My hubby has the same phone, and it's fine on his phone, but it just, for some reason, didn't work on my phone. Now that I'm done with the little things, I'm gonna go ahead and do my today header so I can lay out my full boxes here. And as well, I'm going to just do all my headers, and also I'm going to do my date cover-ups while I'm at it. I'm going to use the Simply Ginger Co. ones here, because this is an undated planner, so there is no dates up here. And then I will be right back. So I'm back with all the covers and everything I need to cover up. So now we're going to put on the full boxes here. I'm going to do the weekend, these two boxes on the weekend, but I'll save that at the end. Well, to do it, because we have to line up, probably we have to start from Monday. So in order to kind of spread out the clocks, I think I do want to do this clock on Monday. Like I said, this is originally supposed to be my kit that I was going to use for New Year's Eve with the clocks and everything. This is kind of like Cinderella, but when you think of clocks, think of countdown, like New Year's and stuff like that. But I am not. So this is like the first full week of January, so it's not too bad yet to use this kit, but I just kind of find it weird to be using like a kit with a clock and the clinking glasses. It's a really pretty kit, and I'm very glad I got it. I just find the colors a little boring with a lot of the kind of taupey, champagne-y kinds of colors in terms of like the checklist and stuff like that. And yeah, just save one that I'm going to be using on the quote box up here. I think I might save that one. There's actually no quote this week. I should have saved that other clock. I didn't think about the one that I put on on Monday. I could technically still take it out. Yes, I'm gonna take this off actually, and then we'll put these two boxes here that kind of make a scene. I like kids that do that for the weekend, which I think is really cute, and I like it how she just kept it in kind of the same normal box sizes as opposed to making them double boxes, because I find those large double boxes are really unfunctional, and I think they look great but they don't function. And I want my planner to look cute but also have lots of functionality to them. So now we have our today section down, our full boxes. Now I can do my sidebar. I'm gonna fold the planner in half so we can go ahead and do my sidebar. And I'll also like zoom in for you guys here so you could see a little bit better. I hope that's a little more zoomed in there. So my sidebar here, I'm gonna do one of the three heart checklists to track my Etsy packages. I did get exactly three Etsy packages this week. Usually, sometimes I get more, sometimes I get less, but I leave only space for three because I don't foresee myself getting more than three in a week, which I think that is a lot, even though I do order a lot of stickers. For my header, I'm going to use one of these. And again, if you follow my videos, you know I like to flip them over and put one of those Happy Mail stickers on there. It looks cuter. And I'm going to use one of these Monday to Sunday full boxes. Here for work, I did start back at work on Tuesday because Monday was in lieu of New Year's Eve. I do get New Year's Day, I mean, it's a stature holiday and I do get that day off, but it was Sunday, so Monday was in lieu of that. And she does give work header. I like that. I just wish she went back into doing like eight headers, eight to do today, and little things we can choose which color we want to use. Even though I don't like this black color and I only want to use one of them, I am forced in a sense to use that one as just like the one, like the way I did it, to only use one of them. And if it was a pretty color, I would want to use like more than one of them, if that makes any sense. And this is just a random to-do list, so I'll just put personal here because it doesn't have any other headers. So yeah, I like when shops give eight so we can have choose which color you want to use less of. And then I'm going to do habit tracker. I like how she gives two habit tracker. I generally do one for vitamins and one for dishes, but I will just use these two because I don't think in my multicolor vitamin one has any colors to match this week, because it's like very neutrally types of colors this week. And then I will do that full box that I saved. And let's see how far up this goes. Because the Happy Planner is larger, like taller slightly, I'm just gonna leave it at that. It kind of like matches up here with the stuff, so I'm not gonna worry about it. If there's extra washi, I might fill up the space later at the very end. So now to the planning for Monday. I want to mark that is in lieu of New Year Day, so we're gonna put a half box there, and she has coordinating half boxes to the full boxes, so we'll put one here for that. I like to mark coffee on Monday. Oh, I always forget to put this one here. My Happy Mail thing. Yeah, so she does give a coffee cup, so I wanted to mark that. My main planner, I also used for the week. This week, I used a winter kit from her, but it was one of her older kits. So it actually came with more of these labels. So I'm actually not going to mark the Coffee Monday until I know that I have enough stickers and stuff to do that. Actually, I'm going to do that. I think I will have enough stickers here. I will put this one here. I'll just have to fill that little space with a little bit of washi first, because I don't like putting a half box and a quarter box right next to each other. All we need is a small, yes, a small strip of washi here. This pattern matches perfectly. I can mark my Coffee Monday. I realize she does give a little bit of appointment labels. She doesn't give as many labels as she does in her old format. This is kind of like the newest reformat of her kits. So I'm going to put a coffee cup there. And there is a sliver of washi, so I'm going to fill that up as well. Let's see. Yes. And I'm going to mark that I did laundry. Monday is usually my huge, huge laundry day. So let's see what color I want to use. I will use this dark one right here. And she just gave a laundry basket, so I'm going to use the laundry basket here. I think that is basically it for Monday. Monday we did just a lot of, like, not really cleaning. We put away all our Christmas stuff and we did a whole thing of, like, sorting out our storage room and things like that. And I do have a little bit of space here. I don't know if I have or I want to have anything to mark that. I will mark a little bit. So I will just use one of the little things here that matches. I don't mark my TV shows, and plus a lot of my TV shows as well are on hiatus right now, but I generally don't mark them. And we have a vacuum. We had to vacuum a lot of the stuff that fell from the tree, a lot of the tinsel and stuff like that. So yeah, I will mark that we took care of that. And on Tuesday, I had a video up, and in her new kits, she doesn't give a lot of the stars and stuff like that, or the hearts, but she does give these that I could just put on there anyway. So I'm just going to put an asterisk one to mark my video that I have up on this day, which was my Christmas week memory keeping plan with me. And I'm just going to use a matching one asterisk there. And that day is back to school, so I want to mark that school is back. I think I might use this one, or I might want to save it for a different day. We'll see. I'm going to use an appointment label, actually, because it kind of matches the color. That school is back, and let's see what kinds of icons I could use for that. I am just going to use a star one here to mark that school is back, because I do work in a daycare and we follow the school system. And then of course I'm going to put a half box down there. And what I use the half box this day for actually is for a movie we watched. Yeah, and I'm going to fill out some space with a little bit of washi first. So I'm going to put this one up here and fill the bottom there with some washi. Oh, it is. I do have this washi here. Perfect. We watched one of the first TV movies that my husband worked on in his current position about a year or two ago. He upgraded. And so this was the first show that he actually worked on his current more upgraded kind of position. So we wanted to watch it. I don't need that extra sliver of washi. And then I'm just going to see if there's any kinds of icons I could use. I'm just going to use the TV one because we did watch it on our TV screen. So I'll just put TV, even though it's actually it's a TV movie, so that kind of makes sense, right? So this day, I just basically, like I said, this was the day that I called my cell phone provider to sort out my phone, and it wasn't stored out or anything like that that day, but that was the day I did that. So on to Wednesday. Wednesday is hump day, so I like to put a half box down. Excuse me, this one here, we don't have the girl on here, but this one's pretty. I thought it would be a nice one to match hump, to mark hump day. The hump day stickers are from Nicole Hutch Designs, and we'll see if we have any matching colors. We'll just have to use the gray ones. Here, yeah, we'll just use the gray color. It matches perfectly. I like marking hump day, especially on a Wednesday that I don't have much going on. And plus in my happy planner, there's a lot of space, so I can mark as much things as I want, I guess. So I'm gonna put some slivers of washi so that I could go ahead and put the laundry. I don't have a lot of washi I could use. I'm gonna use this cloth one here. I'm gonna use two slivers of them there to mark my laundry for the week. And I'm gonna use another flag here. Use this dark one. And she does give a laundry machine, so we're gonna use the laundry machine there. And this day, my hubby had a car appointment. He needed to maintain his car, like after a certain amount of kilometers, you gotta bring your car in for maintenance and stuff like that. We'll see if there's a car icon, which there is. Awesome. And this day we also watched a movie. It's actually called The Accountant. I don't know if you guys heard of it. I am going to put a little thing. I don't want to cover this pretty girl there, so I have a TV little thing. It's kind of like a TV. Like I said, I don't really have any movie things to mark in her kit to use to mark that. So I'm just going to use the little TV thing. Now on to Thursday. Thursday, I did post a video. It was a plan with me for the January monthly spread that was live that day. And I'm going to use one of these. Just a random one. Actually, we're supposed to use a dark one. No, I'm just going to use this one here, and then we're going to use an asterisk here to cover that. Actually didn't really cover it too well. There you go. And this day I also have my cell phone bill that is due, so she does have one bill due here. I'm going to mark that, but first of all, I think I want to put my half box down first here, this one, because I did do a plan with me that day. There is that deco there. I'm not gonna use any flag, but I wanna mark my plan with me this day here. Okay, and I put maybe one or two slivers of washi. Let's see which one. I'm just going to use, again, this clock one here that I have been using with a cell phone. Right there, to just mark that it is a cell phone bill that is due. Now we're on to Friday. Friday's TGIF. Since I do have space, I will mark my TGIF, but I will put a half box first here. We do have matching half box that I could use right there. And my TGIF sticker is from Nicole Hutch Designs. And I'll have to use these gray ones. Actually, I don't want it a little lighter. I'll use a darker charcoal gray black one. It's so pretty to mark that. That day was the day, like I said, I had to do the tech support thing. So I'm going to use an appointment label, I think. Yes, I'm going to use an appointment label, but I'm going to put the washi on first. Then I'm going to put the appointment label, and she does have another cell phone icon here, perfect for that. That I had my tech support for the remote access for them to help me revert back to my old Android system that my phone had before the new update. And then we'll fill that space with a little bit of washi. And Friday we do have laundry, but she only gives two laundry stickers. So I'm going to find some laundry stickers to match that. And I did get some new laundry stickers here, but those ones don't really match. We'll see in here which ones I want to use. Okay, I have these ones. I think I'm gonna use from Simply Ginger Co. because she has these little, like, I guess I'll use this gray looking one. The black is really, really, really black. So I'm gonna use this one here. Yeah, that matches really nicely. That we did laundry, and this was the day at night. Also, my hubby and I, we decided to make me a magic deck, because kids at my work play Magic the Gathering, and I want to learn, and my hubby plays it. He's been playing for a long time. He has like a huge collection, so he helped me make a deck. So I think I'm going to use this half box there, because it was like a big thing and it took like a lot of time during the evening. So we're gonna do that, and let's see what kinds of icons we can use. I don't think there is any icons that we can use for that, so I'm just gonna leave it blank. But we did do that. I didn't make a deck. And now we are on to Saturday. I also posted a video, so we'll see if you have any more of those little things that I could use. We'll use this one because that's the color of the day, and then we'll put an extra dot. At least I like how she at least has these. So if you ever want to change any of your little things to a generic one, you can do so by just putting it like that. And we did groceries, so I'm gonna mark that we did groceries here, and grocery cart here. And and I want to put my weekend banner down on the bottom here. I'm gonna put a couple slivers of washi. See, I only need two slivers of washi there. Put a weekend banner down. And that day went to a friend's house, so I want to put a half box down here. Went to our friend's house, and we actually, my husband plays D&D with his friends, and they have a group that plays D&D, and so we were with our friends, and we just made, they saw this thing online, which you can, the DM, the Dungeon Master, you could create like a little screen, like the D&D sells it, but they saw someone that made it on their own, and they thought it was really cool, so we brought some like foam boards and like styrofoams and stuff, and went there and did it. And I basically just went and helped and painted, helped them paint and stuff like that. So it was pretty cool. So we spent time with our friends there, and I need to put a sliver of washi or two. I am running out of washi here. Kind of sucks. Hopefully I'll have enough for Sunday, which is today. It's Sunday, so we went to church. So I want to put my church sticker with my flag on. All my little slivers of washi are falling off there. We have this one last one we could use here. And then my church stickers are from Sponsored by Coffee. We'll see if we have a matching one. I'm gonna use my station stickers ones because brown matches the taupe a little more, or the tan color a little bit better. So I'm gonna use the station stickers church sticker. And of course, this week at church, I have, like, I help out with the children's programs. So I want to mark that. Also want to mark that we had a soup fundraiser, but there's no labels left. And, we have the cutlery, so we'll just use that. And then we'll use the half box over here that fits perfectly. And then we'll put this one right there. And for children's church, I have these Sunday school, same thing. People call them Sunday school. So I do have Sunday school stickers from, they're not going to match the color scheme, but I'm going to use them anyways. These are from KPL Plans. That's really, really cute there. And also I post on Instagram. So I post on Sunday, the previous week, the full spread. So these are my Murdoch Talks Instagram stickers. I also do them on Monday, and I forgot to put them for Monday, so I will put that for Monday here. Couple more things I just realized I forgot to mark. So on Saturday here, because there's a soup fundraiser, so we did make soup that day. So I do have soup pot stickers, old Nicole Hutch design stickers, if I could find them here. And we do have some of these more taupey brown colors that I actually could use, which is really nice. And on Sunday today, which is today, my husband went and I said he wouldn't play D&D, so we'll see if I have any more game night kinds of stickers. We have this one that I could use right there, and these are from Let's Planet. And last but not least, I want to put my birthday countdowns. I know they don't match, but these are the ones from Hello Petite Paper, and this is my other set that I'm going to be using in my memory keeping planner. So I'm going to flip my planner out for you. So I'm going to put these countdowns down, and we'll start with 31 days, which is on the 5th. Right there, some weeks they'll match, some weeks it won't match, but I'm going to be using a lot of like pinks and purples and kits that are not like a neutral like this. So they should be, in the coming weeks, they should fit really, really nicely. Ones actually fit really nicely in the Erin Condren vertical, like above the days of the week up here, really nicely. So that's what I'm trying to recreate over here. So as you see, they're small, and I like how there's the, it's my birthday, so there's two of them, so I can put one in the like monthly spread and then one in my weekly spread if I want, which is really nice as well. So that's basically it for my video. I really hope you enjoy it. It is a very long video. I'm very sorry about that, but hopefully I got everything and it's really cohesive. Hopefully when I edit this, I will find out. So if you did like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel so you'll be notified when I post videos. And until I see you next time, stay organized.